A medical breakthrough at the UCHealth University of Colorado Hospital, where for the first time a robot has been used to complete a liver transplant surgery.
It is one of just a handful of hospitals nationwide using robots for this type of work. Fox 31's Evan Kruegel speaking with that patient in a story you'll see only here on Fox 31.
Yeah, Erica, pretty cool stuff here. This is what that robot looks like. You can see this surgeon using his hands to manipulate those controls, which control the arms of the robot. The result, pinpoint accuracy and a faster recovery time for patients like Danelle Kuhlman.
Outside the Parker Rec Center, Danelle Kuhlman is back to her normal, active self. Just weeks after donating a portion of her liver, a surgery that normally takes months to recover from.
I am full speed back to normal life. I'm running, I'm active, I'm hiking, I'm out doing yard work.
But Danelle is no ordinary patient. She's the first in Colorado to let a robot help remove a portion of her liver.
So they asked if I was willing to do that, and I said, absolutely. And then I kind of backed up a little bit thinking, wait, what did I just agree to? But even the morning of surgery, driving to the hospital, you know, there was a level of excitement, like, okay, let's do this. I felt like a medical pioneer.
I do believe this will change the future of live donation.
Dr. Thomas Pashak says the robot allows him to see 10 times better than the human eye, giving him even more control over surgery.
The arms, the four robotic arms that go in are all controlled by the surgeon, but in a manner that they're tiny little hands. And in fact, they're even more accurate than the human hand. I can make the robot do things surgically with stitches that I can't do with my hands.
And while Danelle is the first, she hopes she won't be the last.
I will say it's the most rewarding and gratifying thing I've ever done in my life. It's just a less intense procedure, and so hopefully it will get more people to sign up to become a donor.
Yeah, let's hope so. Danelle says she hasn't met the recipient yet, but she's been told it's a local baby who needed that transplant to survive. Doctors are also using this technology for kidney transplants, and they expect this technology to grow quickly in the years to come. Evan Kruegel, Fox 31. All right.